Welcome, my friend. Today we are going to talk about adjustment of valves. Here, this is number one method is the overlap method. This engine is Deutz. This is number one, number two, number three, number four. We are going to work with the overlap method. Overlap method depends on your overlap pistons and adjustment the other piston according to the firing order. Look here, this is TDC mark. This is what we have now. We try to make overlap piston number four. Number four with this mark in the front of the engine explains that the number one or number four in the both are in TDC center, but one in the beginning of suction stroke and the other is bar stroke. Here what we will have to check the overlap of piston number four. We examine this by turn this bushrod. When it stops, this means the valve is open. Both valve intake and exhaust must be the valve is open. This means the bushrod for both is fixed, not move. We have to check. You can see here the bushrod, it does not move. That's mean for both piston, for both valves. Here number one at the top dead center, so we try to adjustment as in the last video. We make a filler. This is a filler. We finish number this valve. This is intake. This is exhaust. We finish both. My advice is that the number of adjustment, the arrangement of adjustments of valves must be according following the firing order to not turn too much. We adjusted the piston number one, so we are going to adjust number three. So if you want to adjust number three, number two must be overlap. So we have to check here. This, you see this valve. This is valve. When it's open, this is intake. When it's open, the piston, this valve is open, and this is open. This means number two at overlap. So look, you look the smallest filler paper cannot enter between the rotor arm and the valve itself. We adjusted number three, finished. After three, the firing order 1, 3, 4, 2. So we are going to adjust number four. By this method, by following the firing order to adjust the valves, you adjust all valves in one revolution and a half, even you have in your engine 100 pistons. So it's an easy way to list the time of adjustment. Now, we try to put in piston number one at overlap position. Look, the filler cannot enter. This means the bushrod is both valves is open. Now, the valves of piston number four is free or release. So though the valves is closed. No press from the rocker arm to the valve. Now we finished number four. We are going to adjust number two. So in this case, we have to make overlap for number three. Overlap one, you adjust four. Overlap four, adjust one. Overlap two, adjust three. According to the firing order. My advice also again, you have to follow the adjustment, the arrangement of adjustment must be following the firing order to minimize time of adjustment. Here we have now finished number two. We have to adjust number two. The method of adjustment is explained in last video, so no need time, no need to make explanation again. Okay. D- d- another piston method is piston by piston by piston. In this case, overlap is valid for the engine 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. But in the case of one piston, this piston by piston is valid for all pistons. It depends on the distance between the beginning of power stroke and the suction stroke is one revolution. So if we go to this piston by itself, we make overlap for piston and turn one revolution. So in this case, the piston will be in the top dead center in the beginning of power stroke. This method is valid for all engine, one cylinder, two cylinders, four cylinder, whatever the number, so it's valid. Here we make overlap, we try to make overlap. This piston, this is exhaust, we have to make overlap here to and turn one revolution to adjust the piston itself. That's the meaning, any piston, if you adjust any piston, you make it at overlap position and turn one revolution. Look, this is free and this is free. This means it's the beginning of power stroke. Again, we make overlap for a piston and turn one revolution. So the piston at the top dead center in the beginning of power stroke. Here, make adjustment. Okay. It's an easy way. It's a good method, like overlap. I prefer this method and overlap, and the catalog, and as I will explain later. Exactly, and good method for adjustment. Finish this one, and go to another valve. Same method for the another piston. Finish this piston. And then go to the another piston and finish the piston, all pistons of adjustment, finish all adjustment of the valves of the engine. So here we don't need to know the firing order. We don't need any information of the firing order, because we'll adjust the valve, valves of the piston itself. We don't need any relation with another piston. Finished. Here, I have to check. Make a check. Okay. You have to feed the filler. If you like, put your the paper filler between your finger. You have to feel this movement. Like same story between the rocker arm and the valve when you put the filler in. Okay, this is another piston. This is intake. We know the valve by the know the manifold itself. You know, this means this is exhaust. This means this is valve is exhaust valve. This is beside the intake manifold. So this one is air valve. Okay, we're finished. Finish this method, okay. So the third method is valve by valve. This is the idea of this one. When the piston is we make exhaust, make exhaust, when the valve exhaust valve is open, that means the intake valve is closed, and the opposite by opposite. And this means this is open, completely open. This means the exhaust is closed. So we have to try this valve by valve, look for the piston itself. When the piston go down, we're going to check now. Look, I try to turn the engine to make the valve it open. Look, this valve is the exhaust valve. Go down, it's open, the valve is open. This means the intake is closed. So we have to adjust. But this method, valve, I don't prefer this method. Valve by valve. Why? Because the cam itself, there are straight partition or part of the drawing of the cam itself. There is portion or part is straight. So I don't prefer this method. Okay. Method number four is the injection time. Injection time, that's if you know the base, you know that's the four stroke suction and then stroke. Before the end of stroke, end of compression stroke, the injector inject full. That means so. If we know the piston inject in this moment, that means we are in the end of compression stroke. In this case, that both valve is closed. As you know, we adjust the valves when it's a screw. Why my method? We see the tier, one tier. If you turn the engine without running, there are tears from the injector itself. You have to notice this one. Look, when the tear down come out, that means the post valve are closed. Okay, this time it's when it's a beer, that means the post piston is closed. Look, it's closed. So in this case, in this time we can adjust the both valves. Like another method, when this follower come in the straight in the position with the straight with this part, in this time that means this start of injection. So we adjust in this way, by another way. The divide method number four or number five is depending in the distance between the firing order between piston number one and the three, or between three and the four, between the four and the two, it's for four cylinder 180 degree. So in this case, this mark explain when this mark explains that one or four at top the center. So in this case, we make here, when this mark here, look. Look, this when the mark is here, one or four at the same time. We divide the flywheel make two point in the flywheel. The distance between them is 180 degree or one half revolution. So in every half revolution, we adjust one of the piston according to the firing order. Does it mean this one? If I adjust number one. And then after half revolution, adjust number three. Then half revolution, adjust number four. And then half revolution, we'll adjust number two. We make a drawing here, 2 points here, 1 point on the bottom also. So in every mark, we adjust one piston. It's the easy way. This is because sometimes we cannot see all these I follow wheel, so it's a good method to see the mark without every time to make overlap, piston overlap, make overlap or not. This is easy way to make the adjustment is easy. So I will use, you know, this mark, and after half revolution mark. So when this mark or this mark go in the front of this bin, you adjust piston according to the firing order. Okay, you can see here every half revolution was just one piston. In six cylinder it will be after we will make three mark. Number this is missing number catalog. Catalog you can see here, it's easy way also. The catalog say both the piston in the tip to center. Top to center, you see this one, this mark in the front of this, both together. So you will adjust half of the valve itself on the of the engine. In this case, look, both this one also this one, you adjust the half of revolution. Here we don't know, we don't need to know the piston, this intake or exhaust, all the number. This is number one, number two, number three, number four, because according to the drawing on the catalog. So we in this case we adjust half of the valves of the engine itself. So look to make this TDC. This one, this means the piston number four is overlap. Both look, the is number four is overlap. Then we adjust number one as overlap method, and we'll take another valve from here. Adjust number one. Both are closed. This is according to the catalog. You must have a catalog. We don't use this method without catalog. Then we'll take this valve from here, this number three. I think this is intake valve. 1, 2, 3. Adjust one. Then go to piston number two. Make mark to not adjust again. Okay. We adjusted three valves. And go to this piston, this valve will open. Now in this position, in the position of the flywheel, we adjust four valves. Then we will turn one revolution again. We turn one revolution to adjust the remainder of the valve itself. It's easy way to minimize time. All this method we try to minimize the time and give this method give good result. But I don't prefer valves by valves. Number three, okay. Then I turned one revolution, so I will adjust the remainder of the valve. We don't adjust this one. Number three, four. In the beginning we adjust the four, and then in the last step we adjust the remainder four valves also. This means we finished all valves. Adjusting all valves itself. Okay, you have to know this. I make it fast the adjustment to minimize time of simulation. But if you want to try, if you want to know how to adjust, return to the last video. This is overhead cam. When the overcam is a bit, the movement in the last video come from cam and bush rod to push the rocker arm. But now if over cam it's clear, so the push is go direct here. So we can when the overhead cam we can adjust the valves here because we don't we see this when the rocker arm in the smallest or the deepest part of the cam, so can enter the cam the filler to see it's correct or not, and then adjust it. This is the way. We don't need the firing order. All this method.